Aristotle was the first to dream of a land that counted the northern continents to balance the two hemispheres.
It was just a myth, but they believed the seas in all directions flowed down towards a towering tree in the south that was home to a giant Garuda bird.
Weilu, a great hole at the bottom of the earth, where the oceans of the world were drained.
Minyaba magru maladain salubisi. Manjan mari kuwe kalinadera. Wagulbia tulimala bembura.
The Dutch passed through the west not long before James Cook came in and put an end to the age-old myths. Prior to that, not even Magellan himself could find it. Terra Australis incognita. She, the land of the south, who wishes to remain concealed.
Vemburata, waebuininya kulengari. Guru, yibinla jaimawayu.
Our family dates right back to the beginning. We arrived on one of the first 11 ships to set sail.
We were promised a life of freedom and riches, a place in the world where we could belong. Struggling families from all four corners flooded to the new world as part of the gold rush. So we sold everything we had for 3 tickets on a ship to Victoria.
After escaping, I found myself on the docks of Melbourne Port. Before I stepped foot off the boat, I was stopped by the port officer to take the dictation test. To enter Australia, I had to write out a 50-word passage in a language chosen by the guards.
The timing was to the minute. As the armies entered the village, my mother went into labour.
My father was a carpenter, beaten to death by police for stealing tools. After his death, our small home became property of the Queen. And so we were left to live on the streets of London.
My father carried her down to the river to give birth. All this while the village was massacred and burned to the ground. He went back to look for the rest of the family. And that was the last time they saw each other.
Ingina Buri Mujin Malayin Kongare. Darling, even Megalin and Nara Wabu.
They tested me in English, French, and Dutch, all of which I passed, of course. And so they went on to tell me that if I could understand a passage in Scottish Gaelic, then I was fit to be Australian.
Without a husband or home, my mother began to sell herself to men. As I spent my days begging and stealing where I could. Not a particularly good thief, I was caught stealing from a lowly court official. My mother tried to stop them from taking me away. And so we were both imprisoned for crimes against the crown.
To be honest, I don't think the guards spoke Scottish Gaelic. But then neither did I. So I made a jump for it. 12 meters later, I lay on the docks with 2 broken legs.
After I was born, mother carry me for 3 days without food before collapsing by the river. We were eventually captured and thrown into a refugee camp, where I spent the first 4 years of my life.
I guess we were just in the wrong cell at the wrong time. Within 2 days, we found ourselves being put into storage for several weeks in ships that would later become known as the First Fleet.
Ingina baja karakareng baduyu kainai longangaru bembluwa kuwi.
The prisoners of the camp were sent on boats to become slaves in neighboring countries. My mother was taken away when the armies withdrew.
We heard the captains of immigrant ships were charged £10 on arrival for every non-European passenger. To avoid the fee, the captain set us down on the edge of the desert. 12 of us were forced off the boat. 3 of us made it across the desert.
Before she left, she told me that life was about finding a path home to yourself. My new family told me we no longer had a home.
Karakareng bembuyu wamabayam dia minya bidang kina kina mirang bembu wakumakang bengkan Brunei.
We paid our dues. Almost 9 months at sea, bound in shackles and rusty chains.
Forced onto a small crowded boat, we were hidden under a large metal sheet. For 2 weeks, we sat in darkness, floating between a life of war and a life unknown.